underneath me. I definitely knew there is a Bombay call, which I was expecting, a good business deal. I couldn't get up from my seat and lift the receiver of the phone, which was just 10 feet away from my seat.
My grandson is crying in the corner. The doorbell rings, phone rings. I can't help anybody. That's the kind of feeling sometimes we get.
That is the time when I feel caged. The mind feels caged in the body because body is unable to deliver what the mind wants to do.
Yeah, I do feel entrapped.
Their minds are active. Their brains are functioning normally. But the body would not respond to the commands of the brain. And it's like an animal that is caged.
It seems to him there are a thousand bars, and behind the bars, no world. As he paces in cramped circles over and over, the movement of his powerful soft strides is like a ritual dance around a center in which a mighty will stands paralyzed.
Actually, I first became aware that there is something wrong with me when I saw a video clip of a show we did at the Rotary Center. I was trying to adjust the mic and I saw that my body was very stiff. My left hand was lying limp against my body and I was trying to adjust the mic only with my right hand. It was a very odd position of the body. And I felt there is something wrong with me.
Parkinson's disease starts very insipidly by not being able to use, in the usual circumstances, one hand. Somebody will come to you saying, I cannot write.
And when other features of Parkinson's disease appear, like a tremor, a couple of falls, the patient gets aware that there is something wrong and then they seek medical advice. Parkinson's disease is a degenerative disease of the brain. The brain produces less chemical called dopamine. And this is the chemical or the wonder drug or the wonder substance that drives our brain and in turn the body. Patients with Parkinson's disease become slow in activities of daily living. They take so much more time to do their day-to-day activities. Their minds are active. Their brains are functioning normally, but the body would not respond to the commands of the brain. And they are sort of almost mannequin-like, stuck in their lives, while the brain is racing away, but the body would not respond to these commands.
Yeah, I miss golf, I miss driving, I miss playing cards. Even cards I can't hold for a long time. So I was very depressed in those days. Very badly depressed.
At the beginning, it wasn't at all easy for us because we could see how his mode of life was changing, how he was slowly becoming dependent and all this. He started withdrawing himself.
Like all patients, he also went through all the phases, including the depression phase.
It was a terrific depression. I even felt committing suicide. Then I realized it's the fact that I have Parkinson's. I have to accept the fact. And I have to live with it.
I got a right to feel low down. I got a right to hang around. Down around the river. And all I see for misery. I got a right to sing the blues.
I'm used to tremors. Only when it is not there, I am more concerned. I saw one lady coming in the opposite direction. She stood there. I understood I'm in trouble. As I was approaching her, she turned around and ran away.
Right to sing the blues. I got the right to moan and sigh. I got the right to sit and cry.
Down this condition.
Around the river. I know the deep blue sea. Mama will be calling me. It must be love, say what you choose. I got a right to sing the blues. But that what is good.
Just 2 minutes. I would have won Oscar Award if I were to act in The Awakening.
He'll never let me out. Place. And they shouldn't. I don't see you anymore.
Take a look at you, then I'm not so blue. When you're would be dancing, that, you know, or he would be trying to move, but he wouldn't. So what I normally do now is I just hug him close to me. I move and I just make him, you know, sway left and right. That's it. That's a way to dance.
Most of them often can continue to lead a fairly satisfying quality of life if they have a caring family, especially the spouse.
Okay, I give him a lot of support, moral support. I help him. I encourage him all the time. I never, even if he says I don't want to go anywhere, but I take him out. I say, doesn't matter, I'm there.
I've always found that the moment one person gets Parkinson's disease, their whole bonding changes. There is so much care, there is so much of giving, and there is so much capacity to take on, year in and year out, the troubles of Parkinson's disease in the family.
When I suffer from the symptoms of the disease, when my medication is low, she comforts me by saying that it doesn't affect her. She likes me the way I am.
My success is my wife. But for her, I don't need her for this at all. I get emotionally excited.
I tell my patients, you are lucky. You are in an era where we can do something. 30, 40 years ago, you would have been in a very bad state. So don't get depressed with what everybody tells you. Take your drugs, you will be functioning over quite some time.
Because this is for the first time that we know where the degeneration of the brain is occurring. We know what chemical is deficient. We also know what chemical to use to replenish that deficiency. So we know the whole cycle. Before the 1960s, patients with Parkinson's disease would live on an average 9 years. Today, with modern treatment, patients live a normal lifespan.
Parkinson's patients, navigating the tricky passage from the land of off to that of on becomes a finely practiced art form. In the off phase, the disease seems to have complete authority over their physical being.
He becomes tired, completely off from his, as if somebody has locked him. So I have to help him to put him in bed, cover him.
In their worst off times, they can experience a full range of classic Parkinsonian symptoms: rigidity, shuffling, tremors, lack of balance, diminished motor control, and the insidious cluster of problems that makes any communication extremely labored and frustrating.
On periods are so nice that you can do anything. I would say anything you can do, but they're very short.
See, it's important to intersperse off periods within your daytime.
So they try and trim the treatment according to their needs.
Because I take 2 to 3 hours off the medicine during the daytime, my evenings are quite productive.
I have a party at 8 o'clock. Let me take a pill at 7:30. By the time I go enter the party at 8 o'clock, my hand will be steady, my speed will be there. So patients
time that treatment according to their need. So that he will see to it that he enters the party at 8 o'clock sharp, because you know he's best then.
Often it's surprising how independent they want to be. They want to be on the road. Doctor, don't touch me, I'll walk. But a stage comes when he requires help. And at that time, the caregiver's burden keeps on increasing physically, financially, emotionally.
Coping with the relentless series of increasing problems, however, is not easy. Coming to terms with their changed personality may sometimes take years. And this is where, along with the understanding family and friends, the support groups can be of great help in infusing a sense of belonging in patients of Parkinson's.
When they have Parkinson's disease, they feel isolated. They feel that, well, I am the only person affected with disease. And suddenly they go to a place where there's a meeting of 50 patients and 100 patients are there. When they see other patients with similar disease, they feel that they are not alone.
Sharing ideas of coping with this ironic disease often helps many Parkinsonians view life with a new purpose and direction, rather than as a tale of woe and pity. What living creature is forgiven if it forsakes its brother? Nothing on the land is single, for we are destined to mingle. So you too are not single. If I pass this way again,
you can rest assured I'll always... After all the help that a patient may get, he may have a very supportive family, there are active lay society in the city where the patient is, very good treatment by a good neurologist. Ultimately, a lot depends on the patient's personality.
Quality of life is so much ingrained in our personality that a disease like Parkinson's cannot affect too much or erode too much of our personality.
Grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, and the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference between the two.
I am at peace with myself. I understand why this has happened. Then I don't have to be guilty about it.
That after 20 years, I'm still able to survive. This gives me a lot of strength.